And we're back! Some more Pillars of Eternity. Let's, let me just check. I think we've been to everything. We just have to go down here and get attacked by things. Or did we go down? I think we went down this way. Oh, there's the supplicant. Ravius. The thing is bugged, saying recall, and it's not time to recall. Let us rest. Okay.
No problem.
We got killed last time. Let's see if we can engage in a parley with these guys instead. Well, what's his name is down there himself. Let's go another way. There's a something. An Andre Titlefest. Let's fight him instead. Maybe we'll level up in the process, and if we have to go through that battle, it'll be easier. Also got a crescent ward here as well. Ooh, cool statue. Like it. We're under attack! Yes, you're so intelligent. Okay, I really didn't want this to be happening. Where's our wizard? Where's our priest? Okay. Now you go forth and knock down the enemy. All right. We can't do that yet. I keep forgetting about those skeletons. Fill them with dread. Is she okay? Oh, she's dazed all of a sudden. Hit him. Ah, chunkage. Love it. It looks like he's facing the other way, this Faithbinder. Finish off this one guy. Cool. Oh yeah, hit him. You got Spectre now. Cool. Those skeletons would have helped with that battle last episode. Are we all attacking, I hope? That's tough, huh? Join the fray! Fun for everybody! God, this guy doesn't ever die! There you go. Oh, that's a specter leaving. I'm like, whoosh!
Quickly and quietly.
Everybody!
Eyes open.
Okay. Fine Morning Star, Exceptional Sword. Shield. We got a moonstone here. I don't want that drink. Blackstone, whatever. Getting rich, though. This one. Plate armor. Fine breastplate. Training grounds construction completed. Good.
Sure.
Musical star on the last. What the hell is this thing? No, this. We only got one now. And that's the South Curtain Wall. Until they undo themselves again, or whatever the hell goes on with that. Let's take a look at this. Potion of Fleet Feet and a balloon. Okay, what is this? The craftsmanship that gave form to this statue appears too skilled and refined to have come from mere mortal hands. That's bad. Bad grammar there. I forget where this guy hides. Where he's hanging out. Abbey of the Fallen Moon is through there. Oh, we're not in the Abbey itself? Oh. Or is that back outside? Good question. An Abbey I thought was a building. Let's go in here. Okay, it's the outside. Okay, the outside is the Abbey. Alright. I just don't want to run into this guy. Inadvertently. I don't remember exactly where he is. Potion of Minor Recovery and the Moonstone. Well, I'm sure it wasn't here. Right? There's an Andrei Crescent Ward coming up behind us. We can't have that. Open fire. That's smart. Everybody, please attack that. Why are we not moving? What the hell? Oh, I died. I did it again. I forgot to switch to melee.
It smells like an ocean breeze. We've got to be close.
Behind us. Finish this one off. Don't heal yourself. No. You don't like that crap. Yay! Find Morningstar, sword, shield, spirit shield potion, money!
I'm here!
How may I help?
By doing something. I'm assuming they're together, just want to check. Yeah. Alright. Sneak mode.
Keeping an eye out.
Stairs up. Three turquoise. Turquoises, whatever. That goes back out? I didn't see that. Oh, the reliquary is right there. So I gotta see, then where's this go? Have I even been over here? I'm not even sure. Probably not. I guess this is where we come across if we had 18 dexterity to go across the arm. Yeah, see, it's all... We got some fog of war.
A simple test.
Oh, a box. A crate.
That's settled.
Plus 5 sword of awesomeness. No. A fine pistol, though. Grow more of the tides. We've actually picked up one of those grimoires before. Scroll of Fireball. Rolling Flame. Fireball. Boop. Alright, cool. And there's all the people we killed. The other entrance right there. I didn't even see this here. I was so distracted by them. So I'm wondering what this other area is for. Halls of Silence. That's a reliquary. I do want to fight this Abbey guy, though. Abbey normal. I could just go right to the reliquary, but I would like to try to fight him. Nothing here. Or deal with him, either one. Crescent War. These guys are so tough sometimes. It's just... They must have really high damage reduction. Question mark. Because it takes us so long just to beat them down. This would be interesting.
This is getting no...
Okay, it's getting nowhere, then let this go somewhere. It's just when they teleport all over the place that just... that messes me up.
Death to our enemy!
And especially when we all run forward. I guess that's in our AI script or something. Intruder! To the vault! To the vault, huh? Oh, she's knocked down, okay. Maneha! Punch! Knock him down. Dragon Leap. Alright, where's Durance? Back off a little bit, since you're not attached here. That will include all of us, that's good. These only affect foe targets. Let me use that. Chaotic Orb. Bloop. If they jump to all different targets. It's pretty neat. Follow the bouncing ball. Armor of Faith. Let's do the bouncing ball again. immune. They're immune to it? That's no good. I do not want immune. Do the scratchy scratch. Damn it. I can get these two guys, or I can get... Yeah. Can I... turn it? I think I hit a dare anyway. I might have. Alos. Wow, I hit him good with that. I guess I'll do it again? Oh, wait. This one. Blessing.
Hey.
Oh, wow. She is injured. She's here. Where is she? In the middle of all this? Somewhere? Where are you? Is she down? 40 points. I literally... She's here, right? Theodos, she's over here. I can't see her for all the spell effects. Alright, so... we'll get her in there. You know what? I think I'm hitting her with that. I interrupted. Oh, and hit DNS for 46. Nice going. Well, I didn't see her there. I saw him. I was just trying to avoid him. I couldn't see her in the middle of all this crap. Be nice if we could, like, turn the map around this way I could see her and, like, level out the camera. I'd be asking for a lot, right? Alright. He's doing that. If we can, lay hands on her. Much better. Now, who's really damaged? This guy is. I don't think... I can't really tell for sure, but I don't think he's... attached there. Okay, so... hit him. Keep changing targets, these guys. Could use a nice clear out here. Is he dead? Yeah, he is dead. Anything else cool? Powerful zeal. Cool. I don't think I've ever used that. That's pretty neat. We're just, like, shocking the guy. Continuously. Nice. I should use that more often. Wow, look at all this stuff. Morningstar, swords, all exceptional, shields. For some reason, they can't have exceptional plate mail. I don't know why that is. Fleet feet, lockpicks, money. These are all the same. Okay.
I'll see what I can find.
No problem.
I'm afraid that here leads up to our friend. I'm pretty sure he's in here? I'm not sure. So, I mean, we are damaged, but I don't want to heal after every freaking fight. Let's check out what's in here. Oh, actually. Oh, the library. Nice. Durance. That was weird. Let him lead the charge.
Hey.
Please come in as well. We'll go no further. Well, I've already made it into the library. Oh, switch back. I don't know why I keep forgetting that. Just suddenly, I just start forgetting things. Or specifically that. Let our priest in. That guy's running around that way, so let's get him. Can Mina hug it past? Bring her over here. She's slowed. Punch that guy. Durance. Holy Radiance. Freezing Pillar of Doom. Theodas, what do you have at your disposal? Mind Plague. Oh, I see a hidden thingy. Oh, right. Durance got hit badly with that. He would like to heal himself. Durance is up here. Yeah, let's try to get Palagina in here. Yeah. Why are you running all over the place? Dragon Strike. Unless you jump twice. Clear out, baby. Is he dead? Looks like that one's dead. Adair killed the Andre Faithbinder, yay! Oh, did we kill this guy too? Nice. So he's the only one left? This one? Apparently.
Eh?
Hey. Get back here. Where do you think you're going? We're gonna rest him. Guy puts up quite a fight. Oh. Oh, he's back there. I don't know if he can reach him. That's it? Good. Whew.
And what does the flame reveal?
It reveals a closed door so no one else bothers us. Find Morning Star, find Quarterstaff, Warbow, Grimoire, Exceptional Robe. Here, I'll take that too. Find Breastplate. All up to the Scale Armor. Two potions of Mirrored Image, a potion of Minor Regeneration, and some money. What about this guy? Potion of Eldritch Aim. And these guys are all connected, right? What's this do? Ah! Scroll of Prayer Against Treachery? Galvanizes the devotion of the party, granting immunity to the charmed and dominated afflictions. Hmm. Could be helpful. I'm probably gonna get rid of all that crap. Wait, that's the treachery. This is the valor. Valor. Because once I take this here, boop. Pretty neat. Jish. Oh, some lockpicks.
Sure.
Find lots of goodies. Abaddon's hands. Selected correspondences of Giftbringer Aben and the enigmatic God of Cold. Ooh. That God of Cold one might be new. Of course, I gotta check. If I have them in here, that means that I've read them. Wait, so what are we looking for? We're looking for blue, like that. Enigmatic God of Cold, right? Brown. Oh, this is the Giftbringer Aben. Right? And this kind of one is Abaddon's hands. I might just have them all. I think they added a couple books for the White March Part 2. But I'm not sure. Yeah, these. Euthanasian Prayer, True Stories in Living Lands, Refined Gentleman. Well, that one might be new then. I'm just double checking. I think at one point I put all the like ones together, you know, matched all the blue ones together, but I think it got rearranged. So let's see. Abaddon's Hands. I'll read it. Of all the stories in Of all the gods, no doubt, one of the most charming is the legend of Abaddon's hands. In some cultures, Abaddon's hands are tiny, cheerful creatures that hide in the walls and in the cracks between paving stones. In others, they are silent men of stone who roam distant lands. In all such tales, however, they are Abaddon's constructs, built in his image to continue his good work of creating strong and wondrous things in this world. Thus, upon spying a mighty mountain peak, or a row of Adra pillars, or another natural marvel, parents and nursemaids will tell young children that these are the work of Abaddon's hands. Such is the appeal of Abaddon as a deity, as it is through his legend that we recognize familiar shapes in the natural world. Thus, when we see a landform that resembles a colonnade, or an arched gate, or a mighty home, we see a hand and a purpose at work that is not unlike our own. And while Abaddon's own identity as a construct is alienating to some, to many of us, his crude yet practical shape is comforting. While the other gods take the form of birds, beast, and sea, Abydon takes the shape of our most common tools and constructions. His debasement in a body of iron elevates our own works and labors, and it offers us a grand hope. For if a god could rebuild himself out of iron, what wonders might Kith create with their own hands? Yeah, that's new. I do not remember reading that. Of course, that's no guarantee. I haven't just forgotten. Monsters of Deadfire. I'm pretty sure I have that. Naasitaq Poetry. The Sea and Her Love. Let's check that. Living Lands. What does it look like again? Like one of these, right? The Sea and Her Love. Light of Dawn. Hold on. Yeah, it's like one of those. We got a blue one, which is Naasitaq Poetry, and a brown one, which is Deadfire Archipelago. And look at the blue ones. Pangram. Really? I'm pretty sure I had that Darkfire Archipelago one. I wonder if I put some in my library, actually. Because I think you can do that upstairs in Cadnua. I know I have Naasitaq Poetry. It's not long, though. Naasitaq Poetry, a compilation. The expedition. I move, but there is no compulsion. It is not a need, but something pulls. I cannot deny its draw. The white wends out past my vision. Its fierce eyes watch me as I move. The wolf tracks my step, a silent companion who will not join. All is blank. The pale expanse lies before and behind. I search. The miles pass, and still my feet move. My hunt continues unabated. The landscape returns my gaze, unaffected by my presence. The snow falls, needles driven by the wind. Its cold teeth bite my skin. The snow gathers, its hand around my feet, or hands, rather, a fierce opponent who will not relent. All is white. My journey continues. I travel. I can no longer stop. A true compulsion forms. The need drives me on. I must see. The sun breaks through the gray. Its unrelenting gaze thaws me. My body warms under its touch. Frigid limbs move again and carry me further. All is empty. The breath of existence is my destination. Okay, so now we have that. The Sea and Her Love. Oh, this is small. This is new. Traditional Andrite hymn. The sea beheld her love, shining bright from on high. She bade him come down from his palace in the sky. Her love could not be swayed, so she took a piece into her heart, and all who saw her grief that day sleep in her bosom still. Just that little bit fulfill all this entire book. Nothing on this table. This table looks interesting, no? Okay. I'm gonna sleep in the library tonight, baby. The Orokian calendar, we have that. The Moons of Eor, I believe. Tides and Moon? That sounds new. The Moons of Eor is kind of grayish. The other two. Tides and Moon, Orokian Calendar. Okay, so the only one I don't have then is... apparently Tides and Moons. Makes sense, all stuff about Andra. We have all heard the legends of Andra and Sen Balefa, and the explanation that the goddess's love for the moon causes the tides, and as men and women of science we know this to be a shadow of the truth. Yet there is another myth that we have been quicker to dismiss, and I wonder if it does not merit further examination. Andrites tell of a smaller moon, Ioni Brethir, that the goddess supposedly pulled from the sky in an earlier age. And while such a thing seems impossible, for Ione Brethair still roams the skies above, it is true that explorers in the far reaches have found mineral fragments that do not naturally occur on any known continent in Eora. Furthermore, naturalists in Adir, Ra'atai, and Adirwood have observed the remains of ancient ocean life many miles inland. Such a thing would only be possible if Eora's oceans had once been larger, or, as here I propose, if a catastrophic flood had once washed over the continents. While few phenomena could cause a flood of this magnitude, a large body falling into the seas just might do the trick. In these pages I will explain how some force of nature, if not an amorous goddess, could have pulled a small moon into Eora millennia ago. I might be getting burned out from reading. Added. Last one. Oh, we got one book here. The Giftbearer's Pilgrimage. It's a blue book. Let me just check. And that. Giftbearer's Pilgrimage. Another new one, huh? Okay. Makes sense. All Andra, yeah. A gift bearer of Andra is traveling along the road when she meets a man in tears, holding a scrap of parchment. "Why do you weep?" asked the gift bearer. "I hold here a letter from my wife. I try to be a good husband, but the letter says that I was not, and that she has gone to seek the company of a better man. Now, this is all that remains of her." "Give the letter to me, then," says the gift bearer, "for once you have forgotten the letter, your wife can cause you no further pain." The man gives her the letter and finds his tears have dried up. He thanks the gift-bearer and leaves at peace. The gift-bearer continues on, contemplating the man's story, but does not get far before she encounters an old woman in tears holding a string of beads. "Why do you weep?" asked the gift-bearer. "I hold here a string of beads that counted the years of my daughter's life. Sickness took her while she was still a child, and she was denied the joys of a full life, and I the joys of a mother. This is all that remains of her." "Give the beads to me, then," says the gift-bearer, "for once you have forgotten the beads, your daughter can truly rest." The old woman gives her the beads and finds her grief no longer gnaws at her soul. She thanks the gift-bearer and leaves at peace. Let me take a drink. Thinking on the woman's pain, the gift-bearer follows the road until she reaches the sea. In her hands she carries the letter and the beads. They are light in her hands, but heavy upon her heart, and she is crying. She prays to Andra to allow the objects to be forgotten and cast them into the water. And yet, long after they have sunk beneath the waves, the gift-bearer finds herself still weeping. "Merciful Andra," pleads the gift-bearer, "in your service I have helped people forget their troubles. Yet, though I pass them on to you, I feel them still as though they were mine. How can this be?" The gift-bearer listens to the wisdom of the crashing waves until she understands. To feel the troubles of others in your soul is a burden itself. However, she has no token to give to Andra to bear it away, for the troubles are not hers to forget. So cast yourself into the sea, right? "I give myself to you, then," says the gift-bearer, "for once I am in your care, no memory may haunt me." And with that, the tide comes forth and embraces the gift-bearer, and when it ebbs, she is gone. Wow. Doesn't sound like a very good occupation to me. Oh, I got an addendum. What's the addendum? "I found a book in the Abbey Library, The Giftbearer's Pilgrimage, that tells of the burdens of being a giftbearer. The lessons contained within may prove valuable." Maybe we can use that in speaking to Kyoto. Resting. Starting a fire in the library. I don't suppose we have any... No. quick save.